Joined by Comets defenseman, Mr. Tyler Wotherspoon. Well, Comets defenseman for now, because you're going to the Olympics to represent Canada. And I want to talk to you about the significance of that announcement, what it means to you. Obviously, you've donned the Canadian jersey before in the World Juniors, but when you have somebody, Canadian committee, going, Tyler Wotherspoon, we need you to be our guy in the Olympics, the biggest stage in the world. What's in your mind? What are you thinking?
Well, it's obviously really special. Coming from Canada, hockey's at top of the list for sports, and to be a part of the biggest stage on the and one of the top countries, it's pretty amazing. I mean, I didn't think I'd have any chance of this, coming into this season. A lot of moving parts this year, but it's obviously a time I'll never forget, and obviously want to go and represent not only my country but New Jersey's organization and. Really play with pride.
You weren't here at the very beginning, came in kind of late to camp. What was it like this summer trying to find somewhere to play and sort of situate yourself as a pro hockey player? You're well established, drafted by Calgary, played in the NHL, but in the summer, I'm sure going in, you're probably wondering where you're going to end up.
There's a lot of uncertainty for some players going into the offseason, and it was a long summer, but I didn't know whether or not I was going to be in North America or go play over in Europe or Russia, and decided and talked with my family, decided where I wanted to give myself the best opportunity, and luckily New Jersey gave me a call and gave me a chance to show myself at camp and really prove myself and hopefully be a part of their organization.
What's it like playing, and you've had different D partners throughout the year, but for the most part, you and Riley Walsh have been paired together. He's got an offensive flair for the game. He thinks the game really well. You two seem to complement each other quite well on the ice.
With his offensive ability, he's got all range to go anywhere on the ice, and with my more defensive, laid-back style, I think that can only be good for each other on the ice. I mean, it kind of gives him a little bit more comfortable, knowing that I'll be back there for him. But over the year, I think he's grown a lot as a defenseman, as a person. Being more mature in his game, I think for guys like that, it's just the little things that they need to, be aware of in the pro hockey. I think that's the biggest step and jump from either college, junior to pro hockey. So I think he's come a long way. He just continues to get better every day.
13 straight wins, a record in the American Hockey League. Never been done before in 85 years. You were on the ice for that game. The crowd was going crazy. The chant of undefeated. I got goosebumps at the end. It was a come from behind game too. Just tell us what it was like to be in the midst of it.
It felt like playoff hockey, to be honest. After going through what we had to go through last year with no fans, I think it really just kind of, like you said, gave you chills during that game to really hear the crowd, feel the atmosphere, and really kind of reminded you why you play the game. And so that was an amazing time. I think it really showed how special our group is and how far we can take this thing if we're all committed, and it's exciting to kind of be a part of a group like that.